Hi, this is Mike Wallach with TriMech, and I want to show you a couple of different ways to rename components in an assembly without breaking references. So here, I want to make this tube transparent so that we can see in here, we have the piston rod and the piston. And then at the end of the piston rod, this part, which is just called nut. Well, I want something more descriptive there. So if I just go to the Windows Explorer and rename that nut to piston nut, then the next time I open this assembly, it's not going to be able to find the component. The reference will be broken, and I'll have to repair that link. So what I'm going to do instead is open this nut by itself. And now I'm going to do a save as. Now I've got the option here to do a save as or save as copy and continue or save as copy and open. If I do save as copy, the assembly references will not be changed. But if I do a save as, then the reference in the assembly that is still open will be updated. So I'm going to do a save as, and now I can just rename this component something else. Well, this is actually not renaming it. It's creating a new one. Okay. Well, that's not actually what I want to do. But if I did do that, this would work. But say I don't want to create a new file. I just want to rename this one. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and close this file. And I'm going to go ahead and close the assembly too. And now I'm going to go to the Windows File Explorer and not just rename this nut right here. If I do that, then I'll break the reference in the assembly. But if I right-click on this, I can access SOLIDWORKS utilities. Now in Windows 10, there was a SOLIDWORKS flyout right here in the context menu. But in Windows 11, they've kind of hidden it from us. We have to hit Show More Options to get the full menu, and there's our SOLIDWORKS file utilities. From here, I can rename the component, and we'll call this piston nut, and you can see it's going to update the reference in the assembly file. So now that file has been renamed, and when I go back to the open dialog and select the assembly and go to references, you can see in the reference list, it's now looking for a file called piston nut instead of just nut. So the reference is intact, and now I can open that assembly, and the component with its new name is right there. I hope you found that useful, and have a good day.